Agenda 20 introduces new ways to stay on top of all your note-taking by only showing the things that matter most. And how that works, we'll show you in this video. So when it comes to good note-taking, there is a fine balance to be found between, on the one hand, capturing all the information that might be relevant, but at the same time, not ending up with a huge note that's hard to read and extract the most essential parts from. So in Agenda 20, we're adding new ways how you can show the things that are most important, but at the same time, keep everything else in case you need to ever get back to it. So how that makes it much easier to stay on top of everything, I'll show you now. So I have this project with a number of origami designs. Each design is a single note, and you can see it contains quite a lot of information. An image, things about how difficult it is, a quote about this design, etc., a number of materials I need, etc. Now of course this is quite a lot of information. And for instance, it's nice to have these quotes, but maybe I don't have to see it all the time, and actually it makes the whole thing a little bit busy and sometimes hard to navigate. So what I can do is put my cursor here in this header and click the button in front of it, which brings up our formatting palette. And this formatting palette now contains a new button here at the top that allows me to fold this particular section and only show the heading, no longer showing the inspirational quote. The fact that this heading is collapsed is indicated by the orange dot in front of the heading. If I click it, it reveals the content again. Now this works for any type of heading, but also in lists. So for example, here at the bottom, I have a tools and materials checklist, which contains a number of things I need for my creations. For instance, the type of papers I need, folding tools, etc. As you can see, for some items, it contains sublists. For instance, certain types of specialized papers. But this might actually just clutter my list. So what I can do is hover my mouse here, click the button in front, and again collapse this subsection, indicated again by the orange dot, making it a lot cleaner. Clicking it again will reveal me the entire list. And of course you'll find keyboard shortcuts for this action as well under the new format text folding menu. Now, of course, this also works in Agenda for iPad and iPhone, but because we don't have a mouse, it works slightly different. Let me show you. Here on my phone, I can access the same origami project. And as you can see, the fact that I folded this heading has also synced to my other devices, as indicated by this orange dot again. But as I mentioned, this dot is rather small to hit with your finger. So instead, folding and unfolding parts of your notes is done through the bar above the keyboard. If I tap on this heading and place the cursor there, the keyboard bar now has this new fold and unfold button. This way I can also clean up my notes on my phone or iPad. So the ability to fold parts of the notes and only show the things that are most important is a so-called premium feature of Agenda. By buying these premium features, you would get a lot more functionality in Agenda and take the app to a whole new level. But perhaps most importantly, you would be supporting me and Drew in continuing to develop Agenda and create new updates like this Agenda 20. Let's continue on that. Now, folding up certain parts of the note might be very useful. There's even a more powerful way to filter notes in Agenda 20. Because now I can filter the contents of a note across my entire project or overview. If I go to the title of this project, for example, I now have a new filter text button. If I click it, I can choose which part of the notes in this project I would like to see. For instance, only the note titles. And boom, all the notes are collapsed to only show the title. I can also show only the headings in addition, or the first paragraph. This way I can quickly get an overview of my project And if I like it and only need this overview most of the time, I can even leave it in this state. How this project is exactly filtered is showing here at the top. You can see it's now only showing the title and the first paragraph. If I would like to remove this filter, I could just click the cross button here. But there is perhaps even a better way. As you can see now that this node is collapsed, there is a new button here in the top right. If I click that, you will see that it temporarily unfolds this node and show all the content. If I click it again, it will just revert. And also if I click it and show all the contents of this node, but then go to a different project and come back, the filter will have been restored. This is a very powerful way to keep, on the one hand, a nice clear overview, but if needed, quickly expand all the parts of a node so you have the full content. Now, importantly, the content that is shown in a filtered state can still be edited. There's no need to expand the full node if you just want to edit what you can already read. For example, if you simply want to quickly check off a checkbox. So, because one of the most useful ways you can use this filter is to, for instance, show only the node title and the unticked nodes. See? Now I have all the stuff I need for my project in one view. If I want to check this item off, I can do so. But to avoid any surprises or nodes disappearing midway editing, the filter is only updated if you move away from the project and come back. See, now I have only one item left for my classic origami crane. So this filter is super powerful, whether you only want to see the unticked items or the ticked items, in combination or not with any other items, like all the block quotes that we talked about earlier, or only those paragraphs that have been highlighted. It's up to you how exactly you want to show the notes, and this can of course be different for each project or overview. And of course, this also allows us to finally bring one of the most requested features that we already partially added in Agenda 19, which is the to-do overview, which now by default will only show you those lines that have an unchecked item. But if you want, you can of course change this to any type of setup that you like. For instance, if I also want to show headings besides just the unticked items. Or for instance, also show the lines with tags that indicate in a different way that this is something I would have to do. Finally, this new way of filtering nodes becomes super powerful in combination with our advanced search that we introduced in Agenda 19. For instance, if I search for specific search terms, I can save this as an overview and choose to only show those lines that match my search terms. Boom, there you go. Now I know what to do for the holidays. Once you start thinking of how you can combine these text filters on top of smart overviews, you can start to create some really powerful workflows. For instance, I can start by creating a smart overview based on the tag priority, and then add the search filter to only show the node title and the first paragraph. If I now want to get an overview of everything that is really important, I jump to this overview. So that's it. It seems simple. Just fold some parts of the notes that are not so important. But in case you would ever need to go back to it, it's all there. But it makes a big difference when you want to stay up on top of things and when you want to quickly see what are the most important parts that I have to keep in mind or that I have to do next. I think this is a great example of the type of updates we would like to continue to bring you with your support. And in the meantime, as I always say at the end of these videos, please go and download the update. Let us know what you think. We love your feedback either here in the comment section of this video or in the Agenda community. And I can't wait to show you what's next in a next video. Bye bye. So when it comes to good note-taking, There is a fine balance to be found between, on the one hand, capturing all the information you might need at a later point again, but at the same time, not ending up with huge notes that are hard to read and difficult to extract the most relevant information from.
Nay, it is not so difficult. Yeah, it's not so hard. Huh? In Agenda 20.
We've got to talk about the premium features. Huh? Oh, you're no longer interested in good note-taking? Okay, go then.